and welcome to my channel. My name is Mary Sakutap Shemes, and today I'm privileged to be joined by my lovely sisters, Amanda.
What's up?
And this is Lakita.
Hi.
All right, so today we're going to be coming to you guys because we're going to be doing a sister tag. We're going to be sharing 10 little secrets, and I hope you guys are going to have fun as we share our secrets with you.
Oh yes.
All right, so I'm going to be looking on their side because I'm going to be reading some of the questions, and one of the questions says, what is one of the products that make you feel like $1 million?
Ooh,
what's that?
I think you're like first.
All right, so I'm kind of like a shoe freak, and I love my shoes. One of the things that really makes me feel like $1 million is, like, I love my heels because I'm kind of like petite, I'm kind of like short, so I really need some help on being pushed up. So definitely one of the products that kind of like really makes me like $1 million is shoes. I must have my shoes.
Well, as for me, I wouldn't lie, my makeup. I love my makeup. At least every time I need to get good makeup, latest makeup, that makes me look fresh and good every time in the morning when I'm going for work, then it makes me feel beautiful.
Yeah. Do you feel like makeup gives you a bit of confidence?
Too much. Because every time, like, when you're sleeping, and then you know, every time when you're sleeping, you go like, probably have been removing a bit of, because it's comfortable, there's a bit of
really too much detail.
You know. Okay, for me, Amanda, I think what makes me $1 million is my panties.
Oh,
yeah. What can hold for parts? Definitely G-strings.
Oh.
I'm a freak of G-strings. And I would wish that.
I don't know about our friends in Ireland.
Oh, yeah.
That's cool.
I won't talk more.
All right, actually, that's the truth. Actually, people say that, for example, sometimes what you put inside makes you feel confident as a woman. And sometimes, you know, my mom always said that when you are going for a road trip, you should always wear proper pants. Because you don't have a black bumper. So those are like 3 secrets. So my sister likes her makeup, makes her feel confident. I love my shoes. My sister loves a G-string. All right. And question 2, it says, what is your skincare secret? Skincare secret. For me, I'm kind of like one of those girls who love my skin to be a bit natural. So I'm kind of like, I like to exfoliate my skin. I love to maintain my skin. I like to soak it with some kind of products. I've got quite a number of products that I use to kind of like maintain my smooth skin. Mm-hmm. And I think one of my secrets, like really, really good secret that I have, is like when I'm going to bed, there's this product that I like to soak, like, you know, like mask my skin.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And when I wake up in the morning, it kind of like looks like really smooth.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I think that's what
I'm just working on your skin.
Yeah, really.
All right, for me, my skin secret, probably thinking in depth about it, I think I won't say it's really a secret because it's more like a home remedy.
Uh-huh.
And basically that's white powder.
Really?
I soak my skin with white powder bedtime.
Yeah.
That's what it does.
It kind of makes the skin.
It dries my skin.
Oh, I see.
So I don't have a problem with
So if you have oily skin, then just to put white.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, wow, I see.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Did you know that?
Okay. As for me, it's very funny. Because I like putting makeup too much, so I don't allow myself going to bed with makeup. So I have to make sure I really clean my, I wash my face, and then afterwards I always leave it dry.
Yeah.
Actually, I leave my skin dry because every time I'm like applying, I'm so much into lotions and all that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so every time I prefer I'm going to bed, I don't put any makeup. I don't put any lotion. So when I wake up in the morning, the lotion which is in my skin comes out a bit.
Oh, yeah. Actually, that's true. People say, like, actually, you should never go to bed with makeup because it's just not good for your skin.
Oh, yeah. But I want to
only. If it becomes easier for
my. In addition of that, probably I'm thinking if your skin is so dry, it becomes a problem the following morning for you to use foundation. Yeah. So again, you find that it's more like a debate to say if you dry your skin.
It depends with the kind of skin that you have. Okay. Like for me, I'm oily, so I remember when I was actually 16, I had a problem with acne.
Oh yes.
Yeah. So I prefer keeping my skin a bit oil, a bit dry most times. Yeah. So. Even when I wake up in the morning, I look like I had applied some lotion. Yeah, and it becomes very easy for my man to, bump up.
Another thing is, can you share your hair secrets? All right, for me, I'm going to go first. Because then for me, I kind of like, I like to be on the natural kind of look. I never like to look so artificial. Mm-hmm. So when I'm going to do like hair secret that I can have, I like my weave on, but I always want my weave on to be like really, when I'm putting on it, it's natural. Mm-hmm. And I also like to maintain my hair, but my hair is really thin, mm-hmm. and it kind of like breaks, so I have to, I cannot just wear my hair just like that, because then it's like it's gonna just fall off.
Yeah.
So I kind of like my wigs, I like my weave on, mm-hmm. and like now I'm kind of like putting on a weave on, but I kind of like my weave on, so I kind of like look like natural hair. I don't like it too much.
Oh, yeah.
Just medium, so I kind of like maintain that natural
realm. I hear you.
Okay. As for me, I like maintaining my hair natural, and I like cutting my hair with very crazy styles.
Yeah, my sister cuts
a bit
hair
on the gangster pair. Yeah. So I most times when I want to look a bit sexy, that's when I would go for like a weave maybe in my hair, and just like that. But I'm always on the natural part. Like I cut my hair most of the times.
Yeah, my sister likes to cut
and
her hair.
I just leave a bit on here. Mm-hmm. You see me soon.
Okay. For me, Amanda, I'm a bit on the lady side.
Yeah.
I love crazy colors for my hair.
Yeah, she likes crazy.
And crazy colors. I am conscious with but I don't want my hair to look extremely big.
Mm-hmm.
Already I know my size of the head. So
it's huge.
Uh-huh. So probably I think I'm a bit free where my hair is concerned. Yeah. I do anything. Provided I'm sure I'm looking good. I don't know how I'm looking right now.
All right. And then another question is, what is your biggest diet rule?
Oh, yes.
Okay. All right. Diet. I'm not going to lie. I don't diet that much.
Okay.
I'm kind of like lucky. I'm kind of like, I've got a petite body. So it's my body never kind of like gets extremely.
Oh, yeah.
But when I gave birth, it kind of like I got myself a pot belly.
That's one part.
So I have to like really do push-ups for that to get rid of my belly. But to be honest, I don't really diet. The only thing I do, I kind of like drink a lot of water.
Okay.
I kind of like maintain my diet. I'm not eating too much. I don't really eat big portions.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of like eat small portions, maybe to kind of like balance up, so I don't really get too full.
Mm-hmm.
So I kind of like have that kind of, I just kind of balance my diet.
Aisha Miss can accept with that.
Yeah, he agrees. My husband knows I don't eat too much. Sometimes. Okay. What's your diet choices?
Okay, for me, as you all know, I'm quite heavy. I'm quite big.
She's voluptuous.
So definitely there's something I always do to help myself and to keep shape.
Mm-hmm.
I always have a heavy breakfast.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Heavy, nice, delicious.
She loves her food.
As the day goes on, I reduce on my eating.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh yes. And of course I drink lots of water.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, I think it's a family thing because I also like drinking water. Like I drink water for a very long time. And then when it comes to eating, like when it comes to my diet, yeah, I don't want to lie. I love food. I'm mostly junk food. She loves junk food. So okay, I eat little as well.
Okay,
I eat little as well. At least if I've missed my breakfast, then I'll make sure I have my lunch.
Oh yeah.
Any workout tips? Like how do you work out?
Okay.
I personally run. Walk. Mm-hmm. And I always do like kind of home workouts. Like I don't really go to the gym, to be honest. I've never been to the gym. I kind of like all the workouts that I do are kind of like self workouts, that I can do push-ups in the morning, I can take long walks, I can do jumps, I can do basically those are the only tips I do. I'm so lazy when it comes to fitness.
like be on pause. I think I'm really sweating.
All right, okay, we're gonna take a commercial break. See you later.
Oh yeah, more time.
How many fire?
And for me, my workout tips is basically I do a lot of skipping.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes, I make it a point at least in a week I do 2 to 3 times. Mm.
Like using the skip.
Oh yes.
Oh, yeah. I see.
Yes. If it's a good morning or if it's a good evening, probably I can do 200 skipping.
Really?
Oh, oh
that's
yes.
Beautiful. That's a show. I wish we had skips.
I'm sorry for that detail, but I really do that.
Okay. I know. Okay, as for me, I don't really touch the gym because I like pumping myself a bit. As you can see, I like muscles, so I like the gym so much. I mostly the treadmill and the lifters. Yeah, really, I'm a bit big this side, so I can maintain it in that
way. That's crazy.
That's crazy. All right, so which perfume is your secret weapon? Which is your favorite perfume? Favorite perfume. Actually, to be honest, myself, I don't really have like a favorite perfume. I like to combine my perfume, but one of my favorite perfume is the Victoria's Secret perfume. I love it because it kind of like smells like a bit of flowery kind of smell. Mm-hmm. You know, this kind of feminine smell
something
that it gives.
Something mild.
Something mild. I don't like really mm-hmm. dramatic perfumes. Like if you're in the room, then everyone's
will be choking.
Yeah, exactly. No. I don't want to choke people. So one of my favorite perfumes is the Victoria's Secret perfume. I really love the Victoria perfumes. Okay. But as for me, I love a Seduction.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I love Seduction, and there is the other one. Let me not forget it because I like combining it with Seduction. Okay.
I wish my husband.
She forgot her perfume.
Okay,
Seduction.
Baketa is still thinking about it. Probably I would say something about that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
For my spray, I prefer using For Sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh yes. Mm-hmm. And then for my perfume, I prefer Fifth Avenue, Elizabeth Eden.
Oh yes.
It's nice.
Oh
yeah. I'm always stick to that one.
Oh, I'm like the scumbag, Victoria's Secret.
Oh, you like Victoria's?
Yeah. That's crazy.
I'll give it a try.
Okay. Tell us, what is your favorite clothing item that you have in your wardrobe that turns heads?
Oh wow!
I like that question.
Oh, I see. That turns heads. Yeah, let's talk about that.
Something that you wear when you wear it, then it turns heads, like men's heads and stuff like that. Alright, for me, my favorite clothing that really turns it when I'm wearing it, it could be a dress.
Mm-hmm.
Because when I'm wearing a dress, I kind of like look really feminine, and I always find myself like, my husband looks at me, other men look at me. My husband likes me to be in a dress because it kind of like makes me look like a girly girl.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I think that really makes me look more sophisticated, more stylish. No, so I'd say really a dress, an airline dress, feminine dresses are for me.
Yes,
okay. As when it comes to me, a short skirt.
Meaning?
Because I've got long
legs.
Long legs.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I've got long
legs. We know she's got long legs.
Yeah, and then when I'm in a short skirt, I always see my husband looking at me. And now the dude's looking, but they can watch, but they can't have.
You can look, can't touch.
Okay, on that, I think I'm so stranded with what to say because I think I haven't really taken note of it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
But you look good in socks as well.
Probably jackets.
Yeah, jackets as
yeah.
well.
Yeah, jackets. Of
big
course,
t-shirts. She's lying. Amanda's got big boobs, and she likes V dresses to expose her.
Oh yeah, you see.
So she's lying. Amanda, she likes to...
That's very drunk. These are my weapons.
Yes. Okay. Then, what is your most treasured piece of jewelry in your just a draw. Okay. Oh, I like pearls.
Oh yeah.
Today I'm not wearing any jewelry because I couldn't find any.
You're crazy, Mary.
Yeah, but I like
my pearls. Where are they?
I don't know. I hope they're not my ones.
No, she didn't steal them from me. Of course, you gave me.
Yeah, I like pearls. I like simple stud earrings.
Oh, yeah.
I just like, you know, I don't like too dramatic earrings, to be honest, or any jewelry that is like too heavy on me. I like it simple. Mm-hmm. Simple and easy.
Okay. Well, as for me, let's see. Just something simple, a simple necklace, and you know.
That's all.
I'm not so much into jewelry.
Mm-hmm.
And my husband, my hubby's ring, yeah, I love it.
Yeah, that's the only jewelry she has, the ring.
Mm-hmm. Okay, for me, probably it's bracelets.
Yeah, bracelets.
Oh, yeah. The statement bangles.
I know you love those.
Something, those lines, something big. It can be something tiny, small.
Yeah.
Mm. But I think I invest more in this.
Mm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Who is your style crush? Who inspires your style? For me, I like Eva Longoria because she's a petite as well. I kind of like the way she dresses. I like her style sense because I kind of like also share her style sense.
Mm-hmm.
I like Kim Kardashian sometimes. Some of the dresses that she wears I like. So I could say between the two, I would go for Eva Longoria.
Okay, and for me, it's Celine Dion.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Oh, yes. She inspires me. Not that I would want to have a lifestyle, but I like the way she plays with her hair, the simple outlook she carries.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yes. So,
so like Celine Dion. You like it simple and chic?
Yes.
Okay. As for me, to be very honest, by Queen Latifah.
Ooh.
I love her style. I just love everything about her. So
oh, yeah.
I like everything about her outfits, her
she's crazy.
Not good to know.
Hey, you know?
Oh, yeah.
She's crazy.
Against the life, because I like against the life. And I love her show. I love her show, eh? That's a show, yeah.
And all right, so the last question is, can you tell us something we don't know about you?
Okay.
Mm. Something you don't know about me. Listen, girls, you know everything about me.
Today I'm here because I'm going to spill it out.
All right, something you don't know about me. Something that you don't know about me is I'm a journalist. I love Borat.
Yes.
That was so heavy. Yeah, I think that's something that people don't know about me, but when I was growing up, I always wanted to be a journalist. That was like my passion. I studied, I done everything.
Yeah.
I was practicing and doing like that. So that was like really something most people don't know, that actually I'm a trained journalist.
And trust me,
I'm a reporter, I'm a broadcaster.
When and she used to go to a mirror and she'd read news.
Yeah, I used to do that. I used to sit in front of the mirror and say, good evening and welcome to the BBC World News. My name is Marissa Queens of Charlotte. Oh, by that time I wasn't married, so I was to say,
Marissa Kumita.
I thought she'd let me compete with her when I don't even know how to read like a journalist.
About you.
Yeah, okay, something you don't know about me. Mm. Okay, I think for my relatives, probably they know that I'm a mother.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yes, I have a beautiful daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Her name is Asha.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, and as I speak right now, she's 9 months. She
yeah,
was born
yeah.
on the 10th of
okay.
March.
Mm-hmm.
That is 2013.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes.
Oh, what you don't know about me? It's for me. I'm actually a medical pharmacist.
Yeah.
I did sexual counseling. Okay.
Mm-hmm. We have a nurse in the midst.
Yes. First aid, please. I've gone for training, like I've gone for Zambia police training.
Yeah, she's a cop.
Then I was chucked out because of
I'm the third.
She's the youngest.
Yeah.
All right, Dawes. I hope you enjoyed our little talk of 10 secrets.
Okay.
Yes. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.
Bye.
Bye.